Your musical favorites on Name That Tune tonight at 7:30.
Good morning, everyone. This is today, Wednesday, November 21st. I'm Tom Brokaw here with Jane Pauley. How are you this morning? As you well know, there's a lot more news this morning, unfortunately. There is more trouble, this time in Pakistan. Young Pakistanis attacked the United States Embassy in Islamabad, the capital. First reports indicate there was gunfire and some casualties. The mob set fire to American vehicles in the embassy parking lot. We get what details there are this morning from Steve Delaney, who is standing by live now at the State Department in Washington. Steve, what do they hear down there?
Tom, the details are still very sketchy. Apparently, the issue of who is in control of the American embassy compound in Islamabad, the capital of Pakistan, is still very much in doubt. The United States, through its embassy in Pakistan, has asked the Pakistanis to help repel the intruders from the embassy. The State Department said a few minutes ago they are now attempting to do that. The implication of that is that the embassy compound is not secure and that there is fighting going on. The State Department's crisis desk is in contact with Americans inside the compound, but they, it is said, are not in a position to see everything that is going on. We don't know yet exactly what group or what goals are involved in this attack on the embassy in Islamabad. It is not absolutely certain that it's connected to what's going on in Iran, but there's nobody around here who would steer you away from that conclusion too far. In addition, the American cultural mission in Rawalpindi has been attacked and burned over the past few hours. And we've just heard from the Ayatollah Khomeini's office that he says it would not be far-fetched to assume that the attack yesterday on the great mosque in Mecca is the responsibility of American criminal imperialism and international Zionism. So things are heating up quite a lot. We don't know a great deal yet, but we are expecting shortly a briefing from State Department spokesman Hodding Carter. Steve Delaney, NBC News, the State Department.
And as soon as we get more information on that attack in Pakistan, we'll get back to you in Tehran this morning. The largest anti-American demonstrations yet. Millions of people in the streets chanting death to the Shah, death to Carter. The streets around the U.S. Embassy and throughout much of the capital, as you can see, are filled this morning with demonstrators chanting in unison.